In the name of God, the holy and undivided Trinity. Amen. So this Sunday, we find Jesus once again hanging out in the temple and telling parables to the chief priests and the elders of the people and the Pharisees. Let me tell you just one more, says Jesus. This is the third in this series, and next week we move on to another place in the Gospels. So I want to say again that the language in this parable can sound like it's pushing people away, like Jesus is drawing a boundary around the kingdom of heaven. And, you know, we get that, especially from the weirdest part of today's reading, where the guy shows up without a wedding robe, and the king says, get him out of here. Send him out to where there's weeping and gnashing of teeth into outer darkness, because he's not wearing a wedding robe. It's a bizarre little story. The best answer that the commentaries give about what's going on is that maybe that wedding robe symbolizes good works in addition to being present at the feast. That he's not appropriately dressed, and that what's happening is that's symbolic of something else. Yeah, it works, given that Matthew's gospel is where later Jesus will say, if you did it to the least of these, or if you did not do it to the least of these, you did it to me, or you did not do it to me. Maybe it is encouraging, this notion that God is leading us deeper and deeper into righteousness and justice. Words that always go together in the First Testament, righteousness and justice. And that God is leading us deeper and deeper into this life that is the kingdom of heaven. Are we all going to get it right here in this world today? Nope. We're not. But the thing is that the invitation is there. God calls us and invites us to learn, to grow, to see and experience this world in a new way, in a different way, to look at things the way God looks at things. So we have a parable today about a wedding feast. A king's son is getting married and he's throwing a big old party. And he sends his servants out to bring the guests, to invite the people, and they refuse the invitation. No, I got other things to do. They mistreat the servants. Nope, I'm not going to come. So the king then, in his wrath, and yeah, you know the story. It just doesn't sound very much like we want Jesus to sound, does it? We all kind of want gentle Jesus, meek and mild, and sometimes we get, you know, Jesus cranky because he didn't have a good breakfast or he didn't sleep well, or, you know, I don't know. But the thing is, in response to these people not coming to the banquet for his son, the king sends his servants out one more time. He says, just bring people. I don't care who they are. I don't care what they've done. I don't care what they've not done. They can be good, they can be bad. Bring them to the table. It sounds like remarkably good news to me. It sounds like what we're being invited to is not just a party, but the party, the banquet, the one that celebrates God's purpose in this world being fulfilled at last. When God's son gets married, marries his bride, the church, if we want to get all churchy about it. That's one way to think about it. But it's a big deal. And I think this is one of those places where it's really easy for us to make the good news not as good as it really is. because we think, well, there's that poor guy that didn't have the right clothes on, and he got kicked out into outer darkness. You know, Jesus tells these parables, you know, and he exaggerates for effect. But the thing is, the good news is actually much better than we imagine. Because if we look back at Isaiah, what did we hear there? It's a test. You'll have to quote it back to me now. I'm just playing. I'm going to tell you. We hear there that on this mountain, God is going to prepare a feast for all peoples. Rich foods, well-aged wines. God's going to destroy the shroud that has hung over all people, namely death. God is going to wipe the tears away from all eyes. See, that sounds a lot better than we think, oh, well, this guy gets kicked out or these people get kicked out. It sounds to me like despite anything that we do or don't do, despite our tendency to run off over here and want to do something else or attend to our own business and not go to the party, God is preparing that banquet. God is working out God's purpose. And thanks be to God, there's nothing I can do to mess it up. Unless I just don't show up for the party. That's not on God, that's on me. But the thing is, this invitation keeps going out. I don't think it's a one-time thing. I think God will take all the time necessary to prepare this banquet. God will keep sending out invitations and keep bringing people in for as long as it takes. And we may think we can mess it up. Well, I'm just not going to that party. If my friend who didn't have the right wedding robe on doesn't get to go, I'm not going to go. But the thing is, we imagine a start and a stop. We imagine that we only have this much time to get something done, to show up for the party. Meanwhile, in eternity, touching all times and all places, God's just having the party. God's just having the banquet. God has the table set and welcomes us no matter when we show up. You know, remember a few weeks ago we had the parable about, you know, some of the servants working in the vineyard, and the ones that didn't start work till 5 o'clock in the afternoon got paid the same as the ones who were there all day. That's good news. That's the sort of thing that we kind of jump into scripture and we put these stories in dialogue. And we look and we see that the prophetic notion all along is this feast on the holy mountain of rich foods, well-aged wines, where God wipes away every tear. And we trust God's grace and we trust God's love. That's what makes the difference for us. It's like the colic said this morning. We pray that God's grace will always precede and follow us so that we will be given to do good works, so that we will be led into God's righteousness and God's justice and God's notion of what this creation should look like. Always, always, always. Seek out God's grace. And always, 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 God's right there. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. Bringing us all home. Saving a place for us all at the table.